Get money. Check it out. You wanna sip mold on my living room floor? Play Nintendo with Season Nino. Pick up my phone saying Papa not home. In the moment. Smoke off, tattoos on, saying B-I-G. Don't ya? What's up, y'all? Look, so today I happen to not stumble upon, because I go searching for this stuff. I go searching for this material. I go on ESPN First Takes channel on YouTube, and they're discussing that, well, Joel Embiid's perception that he feels like Wilt Chamberlain is the GOAT and not Michael Jordan, and the GOAT meaning the greatest of all time. And he stays with the statistics that he had and the accomplishments that he was doing, the stuff that he was doing that nobody has yet to break. He has records that are untouchable, and he feels like, you know, Wilt is the greatest in his opinion. And it could be that he was just bigging up the big man, because the big man is not often recognized as the greatest player of all time, and Joel Embiid is a big man. But he could possibly just feel that. Anyway, in the midst of me looking through the comment section, you know, I go through the comments, I just want to see what people are saying, because I know it's going to trigger a lot of people that just get upset and say, how, you know, a lot of Michael Jordan diehard fans that swear by him get upset if you ever even entertain the notion of somebody being a level above him or the GOAT above him. They get upset, like, you know. So somebody puts, and I guess some people just reference the younger generation. I don't know why this person commented this. They said, people try to clown Michael Jordan and say he's not the GOAT. I don't know how, when you say he's not the GOAT, it's not clowning him. But they'll say something like, I don't know. Dude said, I don't know how people say he's not the GOAT when Mike was scoring 40 on competition that dudes from the 2003 draft couldn't score 20 on. And my whole thoughts was, huh? Couldn't score 20 on? You got to be out your mind, bro. What in the blue hell are you smoking? Because, listen, and I pay all respect, due respect to the generation that came before me in this basketball thing, because I only been watching basketball since I was 5 years old. I was five in 1998, you know what I'm saying? So, yes, I was a small pup, but I got a great memory recollection of sports. But I acknowledge all the great players that came before me. The great Michael Jordan that put Chicago on the map, sports-wise, the Bulls, period, on the map, because it wasn't, I mean, we had players before him, Bob Love, Artis Gilmore, guys like that, but Storm and Norm Van Leer, but Mike elevated us to that championship level, period. I pay all respect to Gary Payton, Karl Malone, John Stockton, Charles Barkley, 6'4", playing the power forward position, phenomenal. But I'm going to tell y'all something right now. You got to be drunk if you think that them players in the 2003 draft would not be able to score 40, or couldn't score 20 on Michael Jordan's competition. I remember Mike saying that Joe Dumars was one of the toughest players that ever guarded him. All respect to Joe Dumars, two-time champion, great Detroit Piston. But I'm going to tell y'all something right now. Dwayne Wade lighting Joe Dumars up, smoking Joe Dumars, and it's not even close. Carmelo Anthony smoking Joe Dumars, lighting him up. It is not even like, people try to say, I don't like when certain people that have a preference for the 90s generation, the 80s generation, maybe it's due to nostalgia that they, this time period has they have a deep connection to that time period, or maybe they just have a bias towards their own generation. But you cannot just come out and say stuff like, the people from the 2003 draft couldn't score 20. What? Chris Bosh couldn't score 20? Being able to stretch the floor too? LeBron James couldn't score 20? Dwayne Wade couldn't score 20? Carmelo Anthony couldn't score 20? Let's be real. Y'all can talk, and hand checking included. I know the era was much more physical back then. I'm not disrespecting it. Yes, they were much more physical. The league was much more passive with the things that they let go, the things they let transpire, like the Jordan rules was created because Mike was getting knocked out of the air when he go to the paint and all of that. Yeah, that's cool. Come with that flying elbow against a dude that's 6'8", 250, 260. and LeBron James. That's cool. But he's not just only just physically imposing. These players today are faster than the players back then. Russell Westbrook them blowing past the competition now. Like, as great as Gary Payton was, as great as a defender as he was, D-Rose gliding past him. And I ain't even talking about D-Rose before the knee injuries. Now, D-Rose gliding past him. Russ gliding past him. D-Wade, he was the Flash for a reason. Like, they gliding past. John Stockton ain't staying in front of them. Ain't not staying in front of these guys. Yes, the era was much more physical. I give you that. But these players today would still have found a way to adjust in that era. They still would have found a way to adjust. These dudes are faster. They're more athletic. A lot of them are more physically imposing. Like, John Stockton ain't ran up on no guard built like Russ. Come on, man. Like, no. Now, I would say Shaq would be able to do damage on these big men now. That's a fact. Shaq would be able to punish these dudes. You got guys like Sean Kemp that would be able to bang on some of these dudes. But LeBron and Wade and them, you couldn't score 20 on them dudes in my generation? Really? Really? And this, Scotty would give people fits. I agree with that. I acknowledge the type of player that Scotty was, the defensive prowess that he had. And Scotty was able to do it all. But even Scotty, oh, look, 6'8", 250, 260, that's too much for Scotty in my opinion. And you can say Magic. Magic didn't have, he guarded Magic when the Bulls played the Lakers in the finals. That's true. Took over the main defensive responsibilities on Magic. Took it from Mike. But Magic didn't have the explosiveness that LeBron had. Not even close to it. So, again, I'm not talking about just, you got to put it all together. They're all their capabilities with the explosiveness, the athleticism. Like, today's athletes are just different type of athletes. With the advancement of, you know, science and the NBA players' bodies and have advanced way beyond the 90s era. So, you got guys now that do things that players back then probably thought was, like, impossible. You know what I'm saying? You know, no, I will take that back, though, because Dominique was doing some incredible things. You had players that was dunking out the gym. But I'm talking about the explosiveness at the point guard, at the point guard position, at the shooting guard position. Like, come on, man. Like, nah, bruh. I can't let people ride on that 2003 draft class and say that none of them guys could score 20 on them guys. Like, what? You don't believe that. You don't believe that Dwayne Wade, a Hall of Fame player, couldn't score 20 on that generation. Like, I know that for a fact. Like, it's not, and I'm not even trying to, any player that, name me a player from Michael Jordan's era that will prevent somebody, LeBron, Wade, Carmelo, or even Chris Bosh from scoring 20 points. 20 points. Matter of fact, I'm going to just leave it at LeBron, Wade, and Melo. Name somebody from that era that's gonna stop them from scoring 20. That's really gonna stop them from scoring 20. They can come with all the flying elbows, WWF moves, all they want to. And eventually you're gonna foul out. You're gonna foul out because they're gonna keep coming, or they're gonna be able to blow past you. Or they're gonna shoot over you. Some of these players bigger than them players back then. Yes, they were long, but and you're right. And I understand people gonna say Robin was 6'6 playing the power forward position. True enough. Michael Jordan, same height. Charles Barkley was 6'4 playing the power forward position. True enough. But again, these dudes now, quicker first step, quicker off their feet, skying for these rebounds. Like, nah, man. Nah. No. John Wall getting past them dudes back from that era. J. Wall, with the handle that he got and quickness, he getting past them guards too. So, I just don't like when people are just so biased toward their era that they're not willing to concede or even think the fact that these guys from that 2003 era. I mean, that 2003 draft class couldn't score 20. Now, I can see if you would have said 40, okay, cool. I still think they would get 40 on that generation, too. But the man said he couldn't score 20. Like, are you drunk? Like, nah, man. At that point, you just being an old school hater, fam. Nah, man. Nobody could score 20 on them. Seriously, I watched Muggsy Bogues just say LeBron James could play at any era with that physicality and that athleticism. You can say all the other stuff you want to. He ain't got the mental toughness, mental fortitude, or whatever. I could argue he may have been even more mentally tougher playing in that era. Possibly. And at the end of the day, that quickness, that athleticism, nah, fam. Nah. Who you sending out there on him? Who? And I just want to know, because who you sending out there on Russell Westbrook? Who you sending? He's not even 2003 draft class. I'm sorry. Who you sending out there on Wade? On Melo? Don't get it twisted. Carmelo, y'all trying to say he a scrub. Now, Carmelo was a walking bucket. He was money. Back you down, spin move, and buckets. Turn around, fade away, either off glass bank or all net, swish. You pick your poison, whatever you want to pick. However you want to do it, he was willing to give it to you. So, y'all tell me what that is, man. I don't know. Am I tripping? Am I just being a young boy that don't know nothing, in your opinion? Or am I saying something that you agree with? Let me know. Because personally, I feel like dudes, when they say stuff like that, oh, they couldn't play in this era, they couldn't play in that era. Like, man, it's only certain players that I feel like guys couldn't contend with. And that's Shaquille O'Neal, the most physically imposing guy that I've ever seen, the most dominant force I've ever seen with my own two eyes in the sport of basketball. Ain't too many people doing nothing with him, especially the big man now. No, they're not as physically imposing. A lot of them are more slender, more slim build, outside of Hassan Whiteside and a couple other guys. But even Hassan, Joel Embiid be giving him fits. Shaq would give that man fits. Oh, Joel too. Joel could probably bang, but Shaq was, oh my God, he was just so dominating, physically imposing. It wasn't much that you could do. Why is this camera doing that? So, y'all let me know if I'm tripping or not. Peace.